In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A very warm welcome to St George's Church in Wolverton for this short act of worship for Remembrance Sunday. Welcome wherever you are from. I am so sorry that we cannot gather as we would normally on Remembrance Day. This church would normally be packed to the rafters as we come to remember those who made the ultimate sacrifice to lay down their life for their country, for their comrades, and for their friends. We'll be reflecting a little of that today. Later in this service, we will go out to the square where, with my colleagues from the churches together in Wolverton, friends and colleagues from the town band, and from Wolverton and Greenleys Town Council, we will remember those who laid down their lives. We will also mark the 2 minute silence. But let's gather our thoughts as we come into this time of worship together. So let's pray. The Lord be with you, and also with you. We begin with a prayer. Almighty God, whose will is to restore all things, in your beloved Son, the King of all, govern the hearts and minds of those in authority, and bring the families of the nations, divided and torn apart by the ravages of sin, to be subject to his just and gentle rule, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our first hymn today is one that we sing almost every Remembrance Sunday. Eternal Father, strong to save. Our reading this morning is read for us by Ian. It's a reading from John's Gospel.
A reading from the book of John, chapter 15. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commandments so that you may love one another. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So this Remembrance Sunday, I have been thinking about chaplains in the war years. What was it like to be the vicar, the padre, during a time of war? What was it like to be in the middle of the conflict amongst the people? I've been thinking about two particular individuals this year. One is a man called Tubby Clayton. He was based in the First World War in Flanders, in a town called Poppering, really not that far away from the place where Wolverton is twinned with. And he was a remarkable man. He was a vicar, ordained, originally born in Australia, but actually from English parents and lived in England from the age of two. But he spent a long time over in Poppering in Talbot House, which was abbreviated to TH, or in the phonetic alphabet that the soldiers spoke, TOC H. He wanted to spread the message of love and hope and peace and friendship. Friendship was very important to Tubby Clayton. He wanted to find a place in Tock H, in Talbot House, where people could find friends and know that they were amongst friends, and where they could find some respite from the difficult lives that they were facing at the front. When the war was over, a great movement was founded called Tock H, and in fact, there was a Tock H branch in Wolverton based on those principles. We still have the banner for Tock H in Wolverton in our church. I've been thinking about what it is to be so devoted to your friendship with someone that you would do anything for them, that you would make the ultimate sacrifice and lay down your life for them. That reading that we had from John's Gospel told us that Jesus did that when he said to his disciples, I lay my life down for you, and no man has greater love than this, than to lay down his life for his friends. And I call you friends. It's a difficult time when many of us are separated right now from our friends and family. I wonder about those individuals, maybe these people who are on our war memorial here in St. George's Church. I wonder what they felt like being separated from their friends and family here when they were fighting on the front. I wonder what it was like when they made the decision to go and to fight. I've also been reflecting on the work of another chaplain, a man called Eric Cordingley. He was a chaplain in the Far East in a prisoner of war camp. He, again, was another remarkable man. He said he found that actually being a padre was quite hard work. He said he often looked around at the situation and thought, what can I offer? Here I am. I can't fight. I can't do anything to change the situation. What does God really want me to do? I sometimes feel like that in the midst of a global pandemic. What can the vicar do? What am I called to do? I cannot save lives. I cannot come up with a vaccine. I cannot help the spread of the virus. What is God calling me to do? What is God calling us as Christians to do? But Eric accordingly wrote a really an amazing set of pieces of reflections and works. And he said the greatest part was when his life was stripped bare to nothing, when they were in the POW camp, and he said, we were all down to bedrock. He said, it made me really, really feel important about my faith. He said, I continued to hold the faith that my family was safe and well back at home, and that I would soon, at some point in the future, get back to meet them on the lawn. I held on to that faith. I held on to that faith with other prisoners who were feeling the same, who were starved and overworked, creating the Burma Railway. There were many who gave their lives, both physically and mentally, in the defense of our country over generations, not just in the First World War, or in the second, but in the many conflicts that have been since. War can rob us of many things. But an important part about it all is that it takes us all back down to the bedrock. What do we wish to stand up for? What do we want to hope in? Where do we believe the point of life is for us? As Christians, for me, as a vicar, I believe that God is my hope. That God is there to represent truth. And that my call is to live in the light of God's love and to proclaim it far and wide. Through acts of kindness and friendship, just as Tubby Clayton argued, to walk alongside those who are making a dreadful journey, just as Eric accordingly did with those POWs who were creating the Burma Railway. Just as many will do and offer continuing Christian ministry in this town during this pandemic, be it through food bank, through making lunches, through offering friendship. When we are down to bedrock, what is important? I pray we hold fast to the faith and we remember the importance of friendship. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
And so I conclude with the Toc H prayer. O God, who hast so wonderfully made Toc H and set us in it to see our duty as thy will, teach us to live together in love, joy and peace, to check all bitterness, to disown discouragement, to practice thanksgiving, and to leap with joy to any task for others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We will shortly go out into the square for our act of remembrance.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome. Normally, as Mayor of Wolverton, I'd be addressing a large gathering of people who have come to pay their respects to those who gave their lives in conflict. This year is different, with crowds restricted and even modest groups of people discouraged. So life is different and some things stay the same. Come what may, we will remember them. All stay safe, look after families and loved ones. We will pull through these hard times, and I look forward to making a more conventional welcome speech next year.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn.
At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Father, we pray for our armed services, for those who are risking their lives today, for those who are serving around the world. May they know your presence. Will you keep them safe? And we pray too for their family and their friends, waiting for their safe return. May they know your peace at this time. Amen.
Father, we pray for the peace of God that passes all understanding, to keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus at this time. And we pray for your peace across this world, across all the nations, across all the tribes, all the peoples of this world.
Loving God, you sent your Son as the Prince of Peace. We pray for those who are caught up in the effects of violence and war around the world, those who are left traumatized or maimed or injured. We pray for the work of the British Legion and Help for Heroes, for those who work with communities that have been damaged, like the poor child. Loving God, we pray for reconciliation and for healing. And so, joining all of our prayers together with the prayer that Jesus taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace?
We will.
Will you seek to heal the wounds of war?
We will.
Will you work for a just future for all humanity?
We will.
We will now say the Kohima epitaph.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
I speak a blessing over us in the name of Jesus, a blessing for all who are serving us overseas and in this country, a blessing over their friends and their family and their loved ones. I speak a blessing over this town of Wolverton, over Milton Keynes, over our country. Bless our government as they lead us through this difficult time. Father, may we know your presence and your grace, and your love and your comfort. In the name of Jesus, amen.